Hello everybody, welcome to the Basic English Diploma first semester. So in this first semester in Basic English, you have 20 chapters. These 20 chapters are again classified as 6 units. Unit 1 is called speaking, unit 2 is called listening, unit 3 is called vocabulary, unit 4 reading, unit 5 grammar, unit 6 writing. In your mid 1 examination, you have 2 units, one is speaking, another one is listening. In unit 1, you have 5 chapters. 1. Need for English. 2. Classroom English. 3. Expressing feelings. 4. Expressing likes and dislikes. 5. Making requests. In Unit 2, Listening, one chapter is there that is called Describing Words. Now, in this first class, we are going to start with Need for English. Chapter 1, Need for English. So before going to start, answer the following questions. What is the medium of instruction in your polytechnic? To answer this question, before, I would like to ask about your medium of instruction, telemedium or English medium, school education. Maybe some of you studied in telemedium, maybe some of you studied in English medium, up to 10th class. But here, in Polytechnic, you have only one kind of one medium of teaching, instruction, that is English. Only in English medium only you learn all subjects, not only English, okay? All subjects are taught in English only. So, to answer this question, what is the medium of instruction in your polytechnic? The answer is English. The medium of instruction in our polytechnic is English. Okay, next. What is your goal and is it possible to reach your goal without good knowledge of English? To answer this question, just think about the world and the surrounding. Can you reach your goal? Suppose I would like to ask you, what is your goal? What is your aim? Maybe some of you say, I want to become an engineer, mechanical engineer, civil engineer, electrical engineer, computer engineer. Okay, because some of you say, I want to become an IAS officer. I want to become an IPS officer. I want to become a scientist. So number of answers, different answers will come. If you see each goal, is it possible without the help of English? No. Because all the higher level education, whatever it is, medicine, engineering, and remaining all subjects are all available in English only. So abundant of knowledge, unlimited knowledge, textbooks are available in English only. So my answer is no to this question. What is your goal? My goal is to become an engineer. And is it possible to reach your goal without good knowledge in English? No. Next question. How do you think English helps you have a good career? So again, it is related to the second question. Career, goal. So, no. English, without English, you cannot achieve your goal or success. So, how do you think English helps? English helps to gain knowledge. If we want to go to America, it is compulsory. So English helps in learning knowledge. Okay. Next. Why is learning English is important? Actually, this question is related to all. Not only English, everything is important. Every language is important. Here, as an English teacher, I have to ask this question. Why is learning English important? Okay. Here, before going to start activity, I would like to say a few words about our mode of learning. In English, it is one kind of workbook like. So we learn English through activities. Through practice. So in every chapter you see activities throughout the subject. You see activities. So activity one. Think of some situations in which you use English. In which situations you use English? Maybe I would like to say few examples. In classroom, we use English. In interviews, job interviews, we use English. Examinations, we use English, etc. There are so many situations are there. So in classrooms, reading books, in the internet center. Internet center means you want to search some information, you want to gather some information. You go to internet center, internet cave. So compulsorily, so the information, whatever you want to gather, you have to search through English only, because internet language is English. Next, with the teachers, you have, while you interact with the teachers, you use English. In examinations, you use English. In offices, In offices, all kinds of notices, circulars, memos, request letters, everything maximum will be in English only. Government GOs, government orders, circulars, everything. Next, in job interviews, with relations, some of your relatives are living in America, Britain, some other countries. Definitely, you have to use English in public places, with friends, in library, at home, sometimes. So these are the situations, some situations in which we use English. So write the order of priority in the space provided below is here. Some of the situations are given. In those situations, we assume that we use English, whether it is correct or not. If yes, that means yes, we use English in the following situations. Then compulsorily, 100% we use English here is the first top priority. And sometimes we use English and some other language is the next priority. So this is the order of priority. Okay. Here I have given some situations. And you can also add some more situations and give priority, order of priority. Is it a way in this situation we use English, in this situation we don't use English, in that way. So, first one, in the classroom, at home, with friends, with the teachers, in the library, in examinations. Okay, now you have to give top priority, first priority, next, second, third, fourth. So in the classrooms, do we use English? Yes. In examinations, do we use English? Yes. With the teachers? So, suppose if I say my order of priority is in examinations, first priority, classroom, second priority, teachers, third priority, library, fourth priority, with friends, fifth priority, at home, sixth priority, in that way. Okay, clear? Next, list out at least 5 important reasons for learning English. This is activity 2 and very, very important in examinations. Here, in your examinations, you get 5 marks, 3 marks question. This is compulsory question. Without this question, you cannot see question paper. So list out at least 5 important reasons for learning English. That means, why should we learn English? Is it compulsory to learn English? Can't we survive? Can't we learn knowledge? Can't we study without English? So this is the thing. Okay. Why English is important? Because my model answers You can add some more, because English is a global language. Why should we learn English? Is it because English is a global language? Why should we learn English? Is English, because of English, we get better employment opportunities. And next, English is a tremendous asset for the professional career. Professional career. Career means job, work. Suppose I am a lecturer. In my career, English helps to get success, to prove myself successful, and also to make learners, students, to get the knowledge. So definitely English helps me in my career. Not only English teacher, it is common. English is compulsory for English teacher. Some other lectures, mathematics, physics, chemistry, electrical, mechanical, along with the subject, English is important. Though the candidate has the knowledge in particular subject, without having the communication skills, English communication skills, he cannot be successful. He cannot go top position. Next, English is a treasure of knowledge. Hundreds, thousands, lakhs of books available in English. All over the world, in every country, we see so many books in English. Next, keeps ahead among others. Definitely, English keeps us in the front row, in the first place, in comparing to your classmates, your friends, and others. That means some of you don't have the knowledge in English, some of you have the knowledge in English. Definitely the student who is able to speak in English, who has communication skills, definitely in the first place in comparing to others. So I have given some examples here, reasons. First one, you can become better educated with the English. You can find more job opportunities. You will know about culture in different areas. People have different culture. South Indian culture, North Indian culture, like that. Next, it is the language of international communication. If you have communication skills in English, you can travel anywhere in the world. You can go America, you can go Africa, you can go Britain. English is the most commonly spoken language in the world. Next, it is the language of international business. English can help you meet new people. Many scientific papers are written in English. English is the language of internet. It is the main language for studying any subject all over the world. So these are the advantages, these are the reasons for learning English? Next, activity 3. This is also second important question from this chapter. Without this question also, you cannot see the question paper. Write the problems you face in learning English. So this is common problem to every student. Everyone wants to learn English. Everyone wants to speak in English fluently. But while learning English, while trying to learn English, students generally face some problems related to English. Not only students, everyone, generally everyone faces some specific problems, common problems. So why write them? Write the problems you face in learning English. Generally, Telugu medium background. 90% of the students in 10-15 years ago, 100% of students. Now it is 50-50 now. In your, if you observe the, in your locality, in your area, out of 10 schools, 9 schools are in English medium. Only one is in Telugu medium. So 90% now the medium of instruction is English only. So, but though it is you are learning in English medium, but remaining, what about you speak in Telugu only in your classrooms? You speak in Telugu, you speak with your friends in Telugu, you speak with your teachers in Telugu, you speak in your home in Telugu, whatever it is. So the main problem is Telugu medium background. The major problem is Telugu medium background. The second problem, difficulty in pronunciation. Difficulty in pronunciation. Suppose P-U-T. What is the pronunciation? P-U-T. Put. B-U-T. Not but. This is but. Why? Because of the some reasons. So you cannot assume P-U-T put, B-U-T, P-U-T is put. So B-U-T is also but. No, B-U-T but. So because of these problems, sometimes you face problem in correct pronunciation, using correct pronunciation. W-O-R-L-D, world, not world. If you pronounce as world, that is wrong. Because of the silent letter or silent. So we have to pronounce it as world. So there are a number of examples are there. Next, lack of communication skills. Communication skills, speaking, listening, reading, writing, all these things. Next, vocabulary problems. Not enough vocabulary to use in your language. While listening, you cannot understand some words because of lack of vocabulary. In speaking, you cannot convey the meaning because of lack of vocabulary. Next, fear of making mistakes. Though you know vocabulary, though you know grammar, you feel some kind of nervous. That is, I may be speaking wrongly. My pronunciation may be wrong. In that way. So, maybe my grammar is not correct. Feeling in that way, people do not speak in English. The main reason is some other person may consider, may laugh at me. Others may laugh at me if I make any problem, a mistake. So, fear of making mistakes. Next, people speak English rarely. In classrooms, with the teachers, parents, friends, relatives, offices, wherever it is. All of you, all of us, try to speak in Telugu or in our other language, Hindi, whatever it is, Urdu, whatever it is. So, rarely people speak in English. So, because of these problems, we face problems in learning English. So, you identified the problems. Why I am unable to speak in English? Why I am unable to write in English? Why I am unable to understand English? So you have the problem. You identify the problem. So you have to solve that problem. How to solve the problems? So suggest some solutions to the problems. Suppose if your problem is Telugu medium background, then it is better. The solution is better to get more exposure to English. Exposure means acquaintance, coming to close, mingle. Suppose you are watching TV, try to watch the English programs, news program, English. You are watching TV, particularly news programs. Instead of watching Telugu news programs, try to watch English news programs. In that way. Next, difficulty in pronunciation. To answer this problem, watching English programs on TV, listening to English news using digital, this may be corrected. Listening to English news using digital dictionaries, we can. So, watching English programs on TV, listening to English news using digital dictionaries, we can overcome this problem. Okay. Next, lack of communication skills. Lack means inadequate, not sufficient, little bit. So to overcome this problem, focus on LSRW. LSRW means listening, speaking, reading, and writing. Next, vocabulary problems. Vocabulary means words. Okay, words. Whatever you have around you, materials, everything, they have names. Whatever you do, action words. So, to develop vocabulary, refer dictionary, read English newspapers, magazines. All these things you have to do regularly. Next, fear of making mistakes. First thing is, very important thing is, never bother about mistakes. If you bother about mistakes, if you concentrate, if you feel nervous regarding mistakes, you cannot speak, you never speak in English. So try to speak in English, whether it is right or wrong, leave it. Try to speak. Practice makes man perfect. Next, people speak English rarely. So to overcome this problem, make habit of speaking and listening and motivate others to speak in English. Your friends in your circle, friends circle, ask them to speak in English. Motivate them to speak in English. Okay, next, difficulty in finding the right word, correct word, suitable word. Beside your laptop, there is a gadget is there, that is device, mouse. You don't know the word mouse. So you face a difficulty. You cannot use that word. You cannot explain it. So, right word. You want to convey something. Speak. You want to say the word speak. You don't know the word speak. Talk. So, how to overcome this problem is, to improve your vocabulary, read English newspapers, magazines, novels. Not only reading magazines, newspapers and novels, you have to maintain separate notebook. Every day, whatever new words you come across, write them in that notebook, separate notebook, and write the parts of speech, meaning and usage, some example sentences. Example sentences, write down. And every day, you have to read them. Just look at them. So, by following all these solutions, you can improve your English. So, some tips. How to improve your English. How to learn English. How to speak English. Some tips are there. Read English newspapers, magazines, and novels. Listen to English news bulletins. Watch English television programs and movies. Speak English with your friends whenever you can. Practice speaking and writing in English on a topic every day. Learn new words with the help of dictionary and use them in writing and conversation. Next, assignment. Read the problems mentioned below in learning English. Select an explanation that addresses and offers a suitable solution. A problem may have more than one suitable solution. So here, there are some problems are given while learning English. How to overcome, how to solve that problem, some solutions are given. But in zigzag. So you have to match them. See here, Telugu as a medium of instruction. fear of making mistakes, difficulty in pronouncing English words, difficulty in finding correct spelling, difficulty in finding right word, speaking and listening English rarely outside the classroom. So you have to match them to the particular problem. Telugu as a medium of instruction, if it is the problem, what is the correct solution? So the right solution, maybe every problem has more than one solution also. Here already mentioned, a problem may have more than one suitable solution. So I think correct answer is E. With a little effort, English can be mastered. It is not too late for you to learn. Okay, you can also add some more solutions. Next, fear of making mistakes. The correct answer is A. Never bother about mistakes. It is common for all in the early stages of learning learning in a language, not only English, in any language. So, however, try to avoid making the same mistake again. Don't do the mistake again. If you know that is a mistake, don't do that again. Next, difficulty in pronouncing English words. So pronunciation is very important. Pronunciation is learned when others speaking are referring dictionary. So watching English television programs, listening to English news, and using digital dictionaries will help you in learning correct pronunciation. Next, difficulty in finding correct spelling. So spelling is very, very important. Calm, C-A-L-M, calm. L is silent here. So English is very difficult. Cunning sub-language here related to spelling and pronunciation also. So many English words are not spelled as they are spoken. They have to be learned consciously, carefully. Reading will help you a lot. Okay, next. Difficulty in finding a right word, right time. So to answer this, improve your vocabulary by reading English newspapers, magazines, and novels. And also one more is Thesaurus, Roger's Thesaurus. Next, speaking and listening English rarely outside the classroom. So solution is identify a friend who is also interested in learning. English and start speaking to him in English. Okay. That is the end of the session. Please watch it, listen it again and again. What you have to do in your notebook is, whatever I have given activities. So important thing, what you have to do is in your notebook, write down situations in which we use English. What are the situations we use? In what are the situations we use English? Write this activity one and write the answers in classroom, reading books. So in your examinations, you have the question. Write the some situations in which we use English. This kind of question you get. So write the answer. So in your FAIR notebook, write activity one and write this question, situations in which you use English, and write the answer. Next, activity two, write the important reasons of learning English. Why should we learn English? I have given some 10 reasons. If you have some more reasons, if you know some more reasons, you can also add. This is activity 2. Next, activity 3. Write in your notebook. What are the problems you face while learning English? What are the solutions? Compulsory. You have to write in the same way. So you can get this kind of question also. Give some tips. You can give some suggestions to improve English. How to improve English? You get this kind of question. How to improve English? Write this question. So write these answers. Read English newspaper, magazines, novels, listen to English news bulletins, watch English television programs and movies, speak English with your friends whenever you can, in that way. So this is also very important. Write it in your notebook. Assignment. Problems and solutions. Maybe this is a repetition. Okay. We shall meet again in the next class. That is classroom English. Okay, bye.